Good afternoon to all, and I hereby welcome Dr. V.J. Hudar sir, and a brief introduction about him. He has done his MD from SDM Udupi and pursued his PhD from KLM, and currently he is working as Associate Professor in the Department of Gaya Chikitsa at All India Institute of Ayurveda, New Delhi. And today he will be sharing his knowledge on understanding of COVID corona disease in Ayurveda. So I hope all the students will gain as much as they can, and I welcome Dr. Hudar sir. So sir, you have the mic, sir.
Okay, thank you for the organizing team for giving me an opportunity to share some of the views related to COVID-19 understanding in Ayurveda. In this, as I got information, the audience are UG students and some of the staff of Prakash Institute. So I will try to make the topic very brief and little crisp so that the UG students can understand, and that will be useful for them to understand and plan the treatment in the final, especially the final year students, to understand how to approach for COVID-19 and understand it. So I will be sharing the screen of my PPT. So can you see this PPT?
Yes, sir. We can, sir.
You can see, no? Okay. So as we have told, so we have a 40 minutes of time in this. So within that, I will try to finish it out in this one. So COVID-19 and Ayurveda perspective, this is the burning problem, and everyone is behind this. So many projects are going on, everything is going on, and all of them are looking towards the solution for this COVID-19 from Ayurveda system of medicine and all Ayush system of medicines, where the allopathy system of medicines are not proven till now. So everyone, including allopathic physicians, are also taking some of the prophylactic medicines also for COVID-19. So in this situation, it is our duty to serve for this COVID-19. So prior to that, we should know what exactly the COVID-19. Everyone know about what is the presentation, this pathogen. It's little bit, just I will go through that, because we need to make a frame out the samprati of this disease, how we can understand. So we should know basic what exactly it is meant by. So with that, we will start with a presentation. So here, can you see the second slide here?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. So all of we know it is an infectious and communicable disease, and it is a viral infection in particular, and its spreading mode is from animal, then human to human it is going on, and it's a droplet infection and surface by the touch and other things what we see nowadays. And outbreak, particularly in winter and spring, it has came out. So all these few points we need to keep it in mind before we understand COVID-19 in Ayurveda. So this is presented with, all of you know, these are the few of the symptoms where it is starting with mild body ache initially. It varies from person to person anyhow. So some few of them will start with a fever first, some of them will start with a dry cough first. But the study on the other side, on the right side of the screen, I am showing the Lancet published article where they have tried to understand which are the symptoms seen earlier and step by step later. So there we can see the, now we can see the moving mouse of, can you see the mouse? Cursor?
Yes,
can you see
sir.
The cursor?
Yes, sir. Yes, 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 sir.
Okay. Okay. So this is the day of the illness in Wuhan. This study has been done. So they try to understand at what time what symptom is going to see. So just intention of showing this slide is how sequentially the symptoms will arrive. Accordingly, we need to understand the samprati of the disease. So here, 1 to 6 working days, there is no any symptoms at all. And then on the 7th day of the working, they have, this is also symptomatic and subjective. And here, so on the 8th day, you can see here on the 8th day, so sorry, this one, see, you can see here, 1 to 6, there is a possibility of cough. and which is persisting till 14 days, may persist for 14 days, it is not compulsory. And chills usually they are seen from 1 to 9 days, and fever usually starts on the 7th day and ends on the 9th day, because here they are administering these medicines. The green strip says that they are administering the medicines at these three different levels. That's why this chills and fever is coming down later. Initially it was 39, 37, 36. Likewise, it is decreasing because they are administering paracetamol and other antibiotics here. So anyhow, we want to know the chronicity. So first is the cough, which is seen, the dry cough, and then the mild fever, sometimes with the chills or without chills, and increased intensity of fever goes on. Intensity is going to increase. Unless we not administer the medicine, the intensity of the fever is going to increase later on. So then lands into pneumonia, and then breathlessness, that is what we say the acute status of breathlessness, and then later leading to the shock. So these are the sequential symptoms. Just keep it in mind. Later we will take up this for the samprapti understanding. So just a pathogenesis in brief. This is the virus, which is a spike S protein, which contains, this virus contains a protein layer, that is S protein. It's called a serine protein. And this protein identifies the transmembrane, that is ACE2, that identifies, this is a cellular membrane. And this protein, and this is the receptor for this protein. And this virus comes to in contact with this membrane, where the ACE2 receptors are there. This protein going to be binding with the help of this ACE2 enzyme, and then it is going to invade inside the cells, and then it makes the inflammatory processes. It starts, and you can see here the cytokine storm syndrome. Usually this word is used, that is cytokine storm syndrome. These are cytokines which are released, which are as a response of this virus. Once this virus is entered into the cell membrane of a cell, for example a lung tissue, there are the cells, it invades, then the cytokine storm syndrome occurs. Cytokine includes some of the pro-inflammatory and anti-inflammatory, both enzymes it contains. So here the cytokines, pro-inflammatory, some of the cytokines are there which will induce the inflammatory process as a protective mechanism against to fight this virus, and some of the cytokines are there which will help to reduce the inflammation which is already occurred. So in this way the mechanism goes, and the macrophage activation syndrome. So macrophages are also activated because of, as a defense mechanism. So these two things are seen in a blood. So whenever this virus enters, then we look into investigations also about these cytokines. So how this is identified, the cytokines in the bloodstream as well as the macrophages and later. So some of the pro-inflammatory stimuli include the foreign antigens, that is cytokines such as IL-6, which are highlighted here. Usually this is considered as the pro-inflammatory, which is the responsible for inflammation of the tissues. IL-6, you can remember here. Many other things are there. We will not go in detail with that. So here, this is the thing. Later what happens, some of the anti-inflammatory stimuli, that is includes these the T cells, that is CD4, CD8 cells and other, you might have heard those things when we talk about immunity related defense mechanism. So this is T cells, CD4 and CD8 counts, and cytokines such as IL-10, particularly IL-10, and many other things are there, growth factors and other things. These will be anti-inflammatory. So these are required actually for the body, which if it is sufficiently present, then the inflammation is definitely going to reduce and the patient becomes free from the symptoms. Okay, this cytokine storm syndrome, you need to remember in the pathogenesis of this. And the laboratory abnormalities include, again, this is some of the cytopenia, increased ferritin level and increased serum levels of the pro-inflammatory cytokines, as I have told, IL-6, IL-10, CD4, CD8, immunoglobulins, all these things. That's why you are checking how the immune response is responding to the this virus. Okay, so then the pathogenesis behind this severe manifestation of the disease appears to be related to the overwhelming inflammatory response. Only everything is going to happen because of this inflammatory response. Whatever we want to do here, one is either we need to kill the virus, or we need to stop entering this virus into the cells by some of the antibodies, either in the form of medicines or by the immune system of the body, so that this inflammation will not proceed further, leading into breathlessness, secondary infections, and then fever, shock, all those things. So this is in brief about the pathogenesis of that disease. So later, so histology and other things will not go in detail, otherwise it will take a lot of time. So without making much delay, just a brief idea we have taken, what are the sequences of those symptoms are coming and what exactly the pathogenesis is going. So once the virus enters into the lung tissue, so there inflammation starts. So dry cough initially starts in this pathogenesis. Later, if it is not treated properly at that time, later this inflammation increases, and then there will be an increase as a response of that, there will be increase in the body temperature, and then again the inflammation increase, go on increasing, breathlessness will start and end up with the breathlessness, that is a acute state of breathlessness, and then landing into shock. Okay, so the same, this is the sequence, what is exactly happening, and in the similar way we try to understand what exactly the symptoms of COVID. So here we'll make our mind towards Ayurveda now. So we have a background about COVID-19. So then now what exactly to go through in our science, it is explained about COVID-19, how to understand this. So first we want to try to understand what is the reason for this outbreak, why this outbreak has came. Okay, so it affecting the large number of people at a time. Okay, so it is a infectious disease, we know, and it is affecting large number of people at a time. So what is it means? We have some of the words in our text. If I tell the all these words, you will come to understand what we are talking about. So this is Mahajana Sevite Api, affecting the large number of people at a time. Mahajana Sevite Api, it happens to large people at a time. And outbreak in a particular season. In a particular season, we have seen this. And in summer, usually, and hot climate, it is going to reduce. And the winter and the spring season, we are seeing this condition as more. So kala, particular kala, this is happening and started from a particular place. That is particular desh it has started, and places where dharma and adharmas, that is adharma is dominating. So there is a spelling mistake. Where adharma is dominating, that is adharma vashat, deshe adharma vashat. So it starts in the places where adharma and papa karmas are more, and afflicted irrespective of kind of a people staying in that area. It doesn't look in this place or outside place or in China or in America, India, it doesn't look any place. So here affected with the irrespective of a kind of people who are staying. Mahajana Sevite Api, large people, and Mahajana means actually the, even though the high economic status people and Satvika people or whatever, all those, anyone is present, is not divided of this infection. So that is Mahajana Sevite, and so outbreak in a place where people stay, that is Janapada Vasati Upalakshitam Mandalam Janapada Mandalam. Okay, so all these points which we see, which is true in case of COVID-19 also. So by these points, you might have come to know the word what I wanted to say there. That is nothing but the Janapadodhams. Yes, it is very simple to understand. So we start our thinking from that area, Janapadodhams. Why we are stressing is how it has came, what exactly the background of this disease. So that is also helpful to plan the treatment. That's why we will come to know in the further slides how it is useful. So if you go through this sloka, the first sloka of that, here in the commentary, if you observe where I have underlined, Sadharanaha Asadharanascha. So that is Sadharana Vyadhi and Asadharana Vyadhi, he has explained there. That is Tatra Sadharanam Pratipurusha Niyatam Vatadi Janaka Vatadi Janakam. So here, if you consider two things, that is Sadharana and Asadharana. That is Bahujana Sadharanam Vata Jala Desha Kala Rupam. Sadharana Vyadhi, that is Janapadodhamsa, Desha, Vata, and Kalas and other things are there, which is considered as the Sadharana Vyadhi. And Asadharana Vyadhi is Vatani Dushitaha, individually, particularly happens to particular person, not all. But we are now seeing either person is doing whatever his lifestyle is, whatever he is taking, or he is indulging in any activities, but irrespective of that, we are getting all the disease. That's why it is categorized under the Sadharana Vyadhi in Janapadottamsa, irrespective of individuality, that is Vata predominancy or any nidana, particular nidanas. So here if you see, particularly he has explained, Mahajana Sevite Api Deshe Adharma Vashad Janapadottamsa Vakshamano Bhavati Iti Darshayati. So here the sinful acts, we need to consider this one. It seems to be what exactly at this context, it doesn't seem, but we need to thought of this also, because this is the main root what they are stressing upon. So sinful acts, particular affected area, and we can see the variation in severity of outbreak in different regions of the world, isn't it? It is not so severe here in our country compared to the other. Whatever measures we have taken, all these practicality things are there, but still we need to understand in a particular place it has happened. So sinful acts and other mass and these things will come, because Janapadottamsa stands for that. We have less treatment modalities, but there is much highlighted in Janapadottamsa Vyadhi. That's why we are highlighting that one in this context. And forecast predictions and other things are told. We will not go much about this in detail about that Janapadottamsa. And again, another point we need to touch here is the Sankramaka Vyadhis. All of you know from second year, final year, you have heard this. Prasangat, Gatar, Samsparshat, Nishwasat, Sahabhojanat, isn't it? So all these are everything you can, one each things you can see, everything is suitable to COVID-19. Prasangat, Gatar, Samsparshat, Nishwasat, Sahabhojanat, Sahashayasanascha, Api, Vastra, Malyanu, Lepanat. So all these are true in case of COVID-19 also. If you do all these things, then Kushtam, Jwarascha, Shoshascha, Nitravishchanda, Yevacha. One of them is Jwara also, which we see in this case. Okay, so that is a Sankramaka Vyadhi. Definitely there is no doubt it is a Sankramaka Vyadhi. So it is well identified in our science also. Just highlighted on the commentaries. Prasangaditi, what is means Prasangad? Prasangena Abhyasena Kritat. Punaha Prunaha Kritadityartha. Is nothing that is very clearly identified. Prasangena Abhyasena Kritat. Abhyasena in the sense, it is not a single time communication, all this prasangat, gatar, samsparshat, it is not a single point. I have done this and it has came, but they have particularly identified prasangena, abhyasena kritat, punaha punaha kritadityartha. Again and again you are coming in contact with such a people, then definitely you are going to be affected with those diseases. And even it is scientifically proved also, particular time if you have exposure of that virus, then only you will be afflicted with. Otherwise, if in a crowd, if you go and immediately if you come, if you have touched something and immediately it may not come. If you stay for 1 hour or 2 hour, repeatedly contacts are there, so then only you will be having a chances of getting that infection. So prasangena. And in that Nayachandrika commentary, if you see, upasargika rogaha samanya adharma pravrutaha masuryadaya. So adharma and other things are coming again and again in the context of this Sankramaka Vyadhi, explained by Sushruta also, he has explained. What is Aupasargika Roga? Aupasargika Roga ha Samanya Adharma Pravrta ha Masuryadaya. Masuraka and other things, what we see, chickenpox, other things, later, previously we have seen the some of the communicable diseases. All those things are, they have considered them plague and other things, they are considered as the Adharma Vashat, they have been taken. And Sankramanti Naran Naram Avishanti. Sankramanti Naran Naram Avishanti. Human to human spread is very clearly mentioned. Naran Naram Avishanti. So that is another one. And Roga Prabhavaditi Anya. Roga Prabhavaditi Anya. So what they will say, if you don't do this also, Prasanga Gatra, so you have not done much also, but there is a one possibility that Roga Prabhavaditi Anya. Even irrespective of Prakriti, Hara, Deha, Dehabala, Satmya, Sattva, Vayasa, and other things. So irrespective of this, of an individual, this disease is going to affect, because there are common factors. Prakriti varies from person to person, but common factors are Vayu, Udaka, Desha and Kala. Due to this, the disease affects commonly to all. And the sinful acts and add upons to these things. Okay, so what we wanted to see here, it is irrespective of individual factors, it is going to affect everyone. And there is a role of, that's why the Janapadottamsa it is called as. Because the common factor we are having is coming in contact is the Vayu, Udaka, Desha and Kal. Okay, so here the factor of Vedic Shamatva, we should not forget this, because it is a very important thing right nowadays, because all the projects whatever things are there, we are all concentrating on increasing the bala of a patient. Vaidik shamatha we are talking about, because prophylaxis and preventive aspects will be related to this only, because we are working on this, and rather than curative, preventive aspects are more popular nowadays. That's why all are looking towards Ayurveda for this. What is an important role in that? Even though everyone is having different Vaidik shamatha, but it is going to affect. But still, we see this asymptomatic cases with a mild symptom of cases, and some become severe comorbid conditions. We see all these things are there, which definitely indicates it depends. The severity of a disease afflicting depends on the individual's bala. So we need to keep our health very fit in terms of prashasta dhatus. Okay, so prashasta dhatus, if you maintain ahara, vihara, achara, everything, if you maintain, so definitely the Vaidik shamatha will be at the optimum level, and some of the medicines are also there, rasayanas and other things, which to keep this bala of a sharira at an optimum level. So treatment of janapadodvamsa also, if you see, chatursho api tu dushteshu kalanteshu yadanaraha beshajena upapadyante na bhavanti aturastada. So here it has been told, and if you see this shloka particularly, here he has explained, esham na mrutyu samanyam samanyam na cha karmanam karma panchavidam tesham beshajam param muchyate. So panchavida, that is the pancha shodhanas have been told. As per the feasibility, we will see how it is feasible. And particularly rasayananam vidivachya upayogaha. Rasayananam vidivachya upayoga. Definitely in case of janapadodamsa vikaras, particularly in COVID in terms of I am talking about. So there we can think of who is fit for shodhana. We can do which type of shodhana can be done. We will see. So if you, after then rasayana and vidivachya upayoga. Rasayana, if you follow for a longer time, then definitely that is going to be helpful in such a condition. So this is the one lead where we can think of the line of treatment from the janapada dosa aspect of aspect. So this is below lines. If you see, only two lines are related to shodhana and rasayana. Other all lines you can see. Sashyate devrittischa beshajaihi puram udratayhi satyam bhute dayam danam balayoho devata archanam sadvrittasya anuvrittischa prashamo bhuktiratmanaha. Isn't it? Hitam janapadanam cha shivanam upasevanam sevanam brahmacharyasya tatayo brahmacharinam sankata dharmashastranam maharshinam jitatmanam dharmika sattika nityam sahasya vriddha sampatahi. All these, if you see, very lengthy, and he has much concentrated on sattvajaya and dayavapasara chikitsa. So which is to be considered in this, because only a few lines of shodhana and rasayana has been told, but you can see all this dayavapasara chikitsa, which is to be taken definitely into consideration for planning the treatment for COVID-19 also, as we are dealing with the janapadodamsa vyadhi. Here if you see the brief explanation of this, what are the factors which are affecting desha, particularly where the papa karma is seen, and sankramaka and epidemic in particular desha, and kala, if you see vasante kapha rogatrat, you see vasante shleshmana tasmat jvara samupajayate, that is prakrita jvara, we can see asatmaja roga, and shita guna kapha vataja vyadi kasa shwasa, all these are the going to happen in a particular season where the COVID-19 has came. All it is true related to kala in janapada dvamsa. And apart from that, grahagati, demons over the divine, bhutabhishanga and viral outbreak, all these agantuja and bhutabhishanga jwara and other things will come in this, that is also related to the kala. And prajnaparada and papa karma, trapa karma, adharma, and not maintaining the proper hygiene, that is ahara vihara and bhutabhishanga, and becomes a pandemic. So this is a just brief to say about how this desha kala and prajnaparada, which is contributing, janapada dosa is contributing for that. So here if you see the samprapti of this, how it might happen. See, now we have a background of how this disease is going to happen. One cause we have seen devayu, desha bala and sankramaka, and janapada dosa, everything we have seen. Sankramaka roga, that is pandemic. Particularly, this is to be considered as agantuja vyadi, because irrespective of our mithyahara viharas and other things, the external factor, something external factor is there, which is directly affecting us. So next it becomes a nija vyadi. So agantuja vyadi, kapha, vata along with the pitta prakopa. Initially kapha, then vata. So later I will explain how these are going to be pivotal role in planning the treatment also, because vata is making a pivotal role in maintaining this kapha and pitta. How this vata is making different symptoms there, what disease needs to be concentrated at planning the treatment, we'll see. So later, once this dosha is going to be vitiated, then it turns into nijavyadi. Then first, as we see, the cough and other things are seen. Dry cough is an initial symptom because of inflammatory process at the alveolar layer at what we have discussed in the pathogenesis. So because of that mild inflammation at that level, the congestion starts, and then that is the symptom of dry cough. Then we have evidence of affecting the pranavasrotas. Nijavyadi dosha prakopa agantuja dosha prakopa kavaigunya is there in the particularly pranavasrotas. That is, ACE2 inhibitors are particularly seen in lung tissue, kidney tissue, and cardiac and other things. So that we can consider that as a kavaigunya. Particularly, it is going to affect that pranavasrotas, and then those pranavasrotas which features are there. If it persists for two to three days, we should look for samatha of the dosha and samatha niramatha of the doshas, and vishata ama and visha as the agantuja vyadi we are considering. There is the abhishangaja, particularly bhutabhishangaja, and bhutabhishangaja in that viral infestations can be considered, which will be presented with a visha like features, samatha and other things, and simultaneously followed by rasavasrotas and raktavasrotas as jwara is a presentation next to the symptoms of respiratory. So there is the evidence of involvement of the rasavasrotas and raktavasrotas also, which will be then presented with kasa shwasa pratishaya, then pratamaka shwasa, the continuation of this. So there it will be there, and rasava here fever you can add in this in between. Then santata jwara and shwasanaka jwara, sannipata jwara line of treatments, and then if not treated at this stage, these all are the stages. Immediately once the dry cough is seen at this level, you can treat, it can be reversed. Once it goes into this samatha and niramatha, then the rasava raktava srotas is affected, then kasa shwasa pratishaya started, then line of treatment changes, and then pratamaka shwasa features with jwara and other things, then little treatment changes, and once it lands into santata jwara, shwasanaka jwara, and sannipata jwara in that form of presentations, so there the line of treatment, intensity of the treatment is going to change. And if not treated, and if the patient is not responding at this level, then it goes to the dhatupaka, and ojo vikriti are seen, and then severity of the symptoms are going to increase, and the patient becomes asadhya, what we see in the COVID-19 within 7 days, 10 days, 12 days or 14 days in that way. So now, in this understanding, with this, what are the line of treatments? How sequentially we need to plan the chikitsa? So first of all, we need to go for dipana pachana, whatever it is, because the patient is, we know the patient is going to land into fever. Once the patient comes to you, the patient will be presenting either with a dry cough along with fever. Then only we will approach. Otherwise, he may not be approaching to you. So in such condition, dipana pachana, it is not like that. The classical things for 7 days like that, we are not. It's not practically possible. At least the drugs which you are choosing to treat that disease should have a property of dipana pachana drugs, or side by anupana, whatever you are giving, that should be having a property of dipana pachana. Then shodhana if possible, that is considering the bala of the patient, what are there, we'll see later. So vyadhi pratyanika chikitsa, vyadhi pratyanika in the sense, particularly dry cough, if it is seen to kasa, whether we to treat shwasa, whether to treat pratamaka shwasa, whether to go for sannipata jwara line of management, whether to go for santata jwara, all these based on the presentation of a patient, different medications can be selected as per the presentation. I am stressing on as per the presentation of a patient, individual assessment is to be done, which dosha pradhanyata and dosha is particularly involved in that particular person. So accordingly, the permutation and combination of the medicines are to be done. So avasthanusara chikitsa particularly, and that is the stage-wise management, and lakshanika chikitsa, sometimes we need to manage only the lakshanas and the upadravas, and later, once the patient get out of those conditions, then rasayana, and visha chikitsa also to be taken care in the whole process, because what we consider, as I explained before, there is a bhutabhishanga and other things, so there visha chikitsa also to be taken care, dushi visha and other things are to be considered, and accordingly the bilva preparations and other things are there which can be added to your prescriptions. here Deepanapachani, usually this is just a sample of medications. I am not exactly the standardized because it is not yet standardized, but commonly we are planning these things. Shadanga Paniya Chitrakadivati, Yoshadivati, which is given for chewing for a patient who is having sore throat or mild dry cough. So in such conditions, this also acts as Deepanapachana drug, and Shadanga Paniya to do the Dahashamana in patients of Jwara also does Deepanapachana, as I have told previously. Those can be used. In the Shodhana process, usually we can go for Koshtashodhana, Anulomana, because Samatha to take out, and Jwarahara Bastis are there if possible. We have not tried this one, but still there is a chances of exploration of these Jwarahara Bastis, and Rasayana Bastis are there, which can be, if opportunities are there, we can thought of completely. That is the monotherapy without any adjuvant therapies. If you are planning, this can, two things can be used as a Shodhana. So Vyadhi Pratyanika Chikitsa, if you are considering or concentrating more on the Jwara, particularly Taruna Jwara, Vata Kaphaja Jwara, Santata Jwara, Shwasanaka Jwara, Sannipataja Jwara, Kasa, particularly Vataja Kasa, and Shwasa, Pratamaka Shwasa, and Pratishaya and Shirashula. Based on the combination of this and the stage of a condition, as I explained in the Samprapti also, so accordingly you need to select a prime drug, which is particularly whether you are treating it for Shwasa, whether you are concentrating more on Kasa, whether you are concentrating more on Jwara, or all together with such a preparations are there which will take care of all these. So such is, things are to be taken care. So that is just a guidelines I am giving. So just a few glances. If I am not running late, I can go quickly with some of the things which are related to the Jwara. Okay. So if you see, yes, the Jwara also, okay. So if you see, go through the Jwara also, Utpatti of Jwara and other things, again all this, the Adhyatma and other things, Adhyatma background will come, isn't it? Shastamo Jwara, Papma, Mrityushcha, Ukta, Amatma Kaha. Utpatti of Jwara, if you see, Adhyatma is there. So it is considered as one, again, Adharma, Papa, Karma, all these things are there. So that is also contributed to that, which we are neglecting actually. So that's why I'm stressing on that. Otherwise, everyone is giving medications. Shodhana we can do, preventive aspects, Vedic Shamatva, all those things we can do, but this is most neglected thing. At this time we can encourage all the patients to go for this type of treatment before who is not affected still with COVID-19 for a preventive aspect. So if you see Asmin Vyakhyane Mrityu Shabdena Mrityu Suchakam Rishtam Uchyate Yato Na Mrityu Reva Mrityu Karo Bhavati, means Jwara is, once the Jwara is seen, it doesn't mean that actually it is Mrityu Suchaka. He says here Mrityu Suchaka means Rishta Muchate. It is considered as Arishta, but it is definitely, it is going to kill. It is not like that, but once the Jwara is there, you should be alert, because the patient may land into trouble and he may die once Jwara comes. That's why he want to show the importance of Jwara. Once involved in any disease, one has to be very careful and immediately needs to be managed as early as possible. Otherwise this Jwara is going to kill the patient. That is the message from that. Okay, so if you consider the different types of Jwara, so Sharirika and Manasika, it is going to affect both the Sharira and Manasa, and it is Agneya, and it is Bahirvegi Jwara, and Prakrita Jwara, as it is going to occur in Vasanta Rutu, and Sadhya Sadhyata also we are going to see, and Santata Jwara you can see here it is. Now Santata Jwara, later it comes. So then Kapha, Pitta, Vata, high fever with Pitta, and Shwasa, Kasa with Kapha. So Yoga Vahi. So here Yogavaha Param Vayuhu Sanyogad Upayartakrit Dahakrit Tejasa Yuktaha Sheetakrit Soma Samsraya. Need to understand this one. Yogavaha Param Vayuhu. So Agantuja Vikara we are considering, Janapadodvansa, Avishangaja Jwara, all these we are considering. Initially it is going to be afflicted with Tridosha. We have to be tackling with Tridosha, but see, this one needs to be concentrated. Yogavaha Param Vayuhu Sanyogad Ubhyarthakrit. So it is present, and Dahakrit Tejasa Yuktaha. If it is going to Vata, if it is mixed with Pitta, then Dahakrit Tejasaha Yuktaha Sheetakrit Soma Samsraya. So there also you can see two types of presentations in COVID presentation. There if it is Vata, if it is mixing with the Kapha, then Sheetakrit Soma Samsraya Shwasa Kapha Vriddhi, all these things, inflammations, other things are there. But here if it is mixed with the Pitta, then Dahakrit Tejasa, Jwara and other things are there. So Vayu is, how this Vayu is mixing with which Dosha and which dosha is it is afflicting. Accordingly, the presentations are there. And main culprit, what we wanted to highlight is vata here. We'll come to know that in Sannipataja Jwara, how the presentation of Sannipataja Jwara is there. So asadhyata is very clearly told, which is, seems to be practical at this context. Everyone knows the shlokas, but at this context, how it is going to be applicable, we should understand. Saptaha dva, dashaha dva, dvadashaha tataivacha, sa pralapa brahma, shwasa stikshna. Okay, saptaha dvatottare, paitike dashaha kafaje dvada. So likewise, you can go through, because everything cannot be covered in a single lecture. So it is, each and every chapter is to be read and understood properly to synchronize all those things and to come to a conclusion and then plan the treatment. But just I am giving some of the hints. You can go through these things and later you can think over that. Jwaras tikshnaha shunascha gambhiro dhairga ratrikaha. So what we say, the asadhyata of the jwara, if it is left for a longer time, if it is not treated after 12 days also, then definitely it's going to become asadhya and it is going to kill the patient. That's why 7 days, 10 days, 12 days maximum. So within that we need to control the disease. How practical is it? Saptaha, dashaha, dvadashaha. So that is the practical thing. Gambhiraha, antarvegaha, kimva, gambhira dhatustaha, dairga ratrika, dirga kalanubandhi. Dirga kalanubandhi jwara is considered as asadhya. So as early as possible you need to tackle with the jwara symptom. So santata jwara, I will not again go in detail with, but highlighted only I am going to show here. Kala dusha prakritir bir dosha stulyo hi santatam. So kala, vasanta rutu, dusha is rasa, what we are, rasa is also involved here. Prakriti is kapha, if person is having kapha prakriti, and dosha is kapha. So in such a conditions, santata jwara is the manifestation of santata jwara. Kaladi tulyataha doshasya kadachit sambhavanti yataha vasante shleshmakrita, the same thing which is explained here. Okay, so then here sa shudhyaha vapi ashudhya va prasadinam. So here the shodhana has been explained. Saptahadishu kaleshu prashamam yati hantiva. This is very important. So if you consider santata jwara, continuously fever is present to such a patients, only when you give a paracetamol or any other jwaragna aushadis, then at that time you may the patient may be free from jwara, but continuously there will be fever in COVID-19. So based on that, or the involvement of the rasadhatu and the presentation of tridoshas and the presentation, if you see, the santata jwara can be thought of, and from that the management line can also be taken. Here the shodhana concept has came, isn't it? So sa shudhyaha va api ashudhyava sadinam asheshata saptahadishu kaleshu. So 7 days he needs to be controlled, otherwise prashamam yati hantiva. Within that, if you treat well, then it is going to be recovered, otherwise it is going to harm or kill the patient. So okay, so this is the last line also I have highlighted. Priya krama vidau yuktaha prayaha pragapatarpanaihi. So prayaha pragapatar, always continuously karsana should not be done, but it should be balanced. But priority of your treatment goal should be apatarpana line of management in such a conditions. So this is about this, and the Sannipataja Jwara, very important to see. Just this is a combination of the Sannipataja Jwara presenting with shwasa, kasaha, pratishayo, mukashosho, atiparshvaruk, kafahine, pitta madhye lingam, vata adike matam. Okay, so this is the one state of a Sannipataja Jwara which is exactly matching with the present symptoms of COVID-19, and accordingly, directly, ready-madely, you will get the severity of the doshas, and you need to concentrate while planning the treatment. Shwasa kasa is there, pratishayo, mukashosho, ati, parshwaru. And jwara will be there, obviously jwara will be there, because we are talking about Sannipataja Jwara there. And kapha hine, kapha is less there. Pitta madhye lingam vatadike matam. Vatadika is there, pitta madhye is there, that's why fever is more seen in that condition. Kapahine, less symptoms of, initially less symptoms of respiratory symptoms are there, then increase in the intensity of jwara because of vata and pitta, and later, if not treated, again kapha takes over, and then vata and kapha together may cause a more breathlessness, and then vata is also responsible for severity of shwasa. As we know, the shwasa samprapti there. So accordingly, in this overall what I wanted to say is in the particular state of the Sanipathmisis Jwara, this is the combination of diseases. Vata adhike. Vata is predominant. Next is Pitta. Next is Kapha. In that way, you need to plan the Shamanaushadhis which you are planning about. Okay. So this is Agantuja Jwara. Also be planned if the patient is durbala, not fit for Oman or Virechana, and Nasya Jirna Jwara with heaviness in the head, if it is there, then Nasya can also be planned at different stages. And if Jwara is there, you are planning these drugs, Mahasudarshana Ganavati, Samshamanivati, Tribhuvana Kirti Rasa, Amrutarishta, Amrutottara Kashaya. These are few of the options based on the condition you have to select. Just it is based on the yukti of a person. Just I have given how to understand that particular samprapti and the predominance of the dosha. Accordingly, one can select these drugs. Okay. So, dhatugata jwara, vishama jwara, in such conditions, you can go more intense line of treatment where Mrityunjaya rasa, Jayamangala rasa, vishama jwarantaka loha, and vasa guduchadi kashaya can be used in such a conditions of dhatugata jwara. And shwasa and pratishaya, usually in practice, I am telling about all these which are available in the market. Pali Sadi Churna and Estrin are the combinations. Kanakasava, Shwasakasa Chintamani with gold is also working very well, and this can be a very good option right now. Naradiya Lakshmi Vilasa Rasa with Tambula Swarasa, and Vishachikitsa Bilwadi Gutika and Vetumaran, which is used in Kerala region. And the Rasayanas, Agastya Rasayana, Chavana Prashavaleha, Samchamani Vati, Kavala and Gandusha can be done. Dupana Karma with Aparajita or Homa. And home and other things can be done for a post recovery as a prophylaxis. These are the things or the drugs which can be used. So these are the few things which I have tried to highlight and give just a ignition. Otherwise it is a very lengthy, each and everything needs to be analyzed with the commentaries, but it may not be possible in 40 minutes. So just I have given some of the, I hope I have given some of the thought points, starting from the cause of that Janapada Dhamsa, Vedic Shamatva, how Jwara and Shwasa, different srotasas, pranava, rasava, raktava srotas, and agantuja vyadhis, all these concepts together, how can be understood, and finally coming with some of the protocol. So if any doubts, you can ask within a few minutes later. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir, for such a knowledgeable session. All the students, if someone has any query, they can unmute them and ask a question from the sir. किसी को कोई भी क्वेरी हो तो अपने आप को अनम्यूट कर सकता है और सर से क्वेश्चन पूछ सकता है. दे आर मोस्ट वेलकम.
हेलो सर, गुड आफ्टरनून सर, आई एम प्रणव.
ओके
सर, एक्चुअली आई वांट टू आस्क कि यू मेंशनड सन्निपात ज्वर इज सिमिलर टू द कोविड 19 सिचुएशन एंड बट हियर द कफ इज लेस. And we knew that basically the pneumonic condition occurred in the COVID-19 situation. So yes. How can we correlate this and all?
Okay, I tried to address that one in a hurry. It has not become clear, I think. Just again, I will clear it. As I am not exactly telling that this condition only, whole process of that COVID course should not be taken as Sanipata Jwara. So initially, if one comes to you with a mild body ache with a dry cough, what is your diagnosis? There we cannot see it as a Sanipata Jwara. So there I will take it as a line of management of Vataja Kasa. Okay. So there I will give some of the medications. If that is not in that condition, there will be Vata and mild cough roll will be there. So in the next stage, if when the patient lands into fever, there the role of cough, always kapha is there. As I told, it is a tridosha vyadhi. But initially kapha role and vata is there. So later the kapha remains as it is, but the role of this pitta, slowly this pitta is taking its role in the manifestation as either the pathogenesis if you see, or the different involvement of whatever may be the causative factor or the nature of the disease, whatever it is, Pitta is becoming, at that stage, it is becoming predominant, and Vata and Pitta together, that they are forming the presentation of Jwara particularly. And later stage, if it becomes so severe, a high degree of fever in such conditions, you can consider mild cough is there, but high degree of fever is there. So there you can consider the different Taruna Jwara and other things will come initially. So there we don't have that much of practically to think. We don't have, as we theoretically say like this, there is no time to say that Taruna Jwara is started, now I'll go for only Langana and other things, and later I will add some of the medicines for Sannipata Jwara. So the presentation what he has given in Sannipata Jwara, because we know the severity of the disease, 2 to 3 days it is going to land into different conditions. That's why we need to think in a higher or a later stage of the Jwara, where Vata and Pitta together along with Kapha, Sannipata Jwara feature will come in the middle. And the later what I have told, you are telling about pneumonia and breathlessness, at the later stage it happens gradually along with the fever. Fever will subside because of the treatment, but this pneumonia and breathlessness, what we say acute respiratory distress, in the, such conditions, again it goes to Shwasa Chikitsa. As I have told, mild fever with a presentation of Shwasa, sir, there Prathamaka Shwasa and Shwasa line of treatment we need to go for. Such a medicines are also in allopathy also you take, in our also, condition, in this one also, we will concentrate more on Shwasa Chikitsa rather than Jwara Chikitsa there. In the later stage of that, again, later in the shock and other conditions, there again Murcha and Sanyas, other things will come later. So other medications we are using at that stage. We need to divide as per the presentation in these conditions. In the middle, what I have told, Kapha is less, Pitta is more, and Vata is regulating this Vata and Pitta together. They are forming the Sannipata Jwara, particular variety of that, which is presenting with Shwasa, Kasa, Pratishaya, and other features are mentioned in Sannipata Jwara. Many other may be present, but only 3-4 symptoms they have given. Jwara is not there in that, isn't it? It doesn't mean that patient is not having Jwara. Jwara is obvious thing, Jwara patient will be having. Along with that, Shwasa, Kasa, Pratishaya, if you screen all the types of Jwaras, in the Sannipata Jwara, different varieties, you will get this one only, which is matching to the COVID-19.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Any other questions?
Any more questions? कोई भी कोई क्वेरी हो, कोई डाउट हो, अभी सर से पूछ सकते हैं आप. We have very little time left, so जिसको भी जो क्वेश्चन पूछने, be fast. If there is any query,
or anybody is interested to talk to me later, you can mail me some of your queries, your opinions, contradictions, because all this is a discussion which is new thing, need to be established, need to be understood clinically, and then we need to come to a conclusion. So if you are having any personal interest in understanding and making a discussion, you can take my mail and you can mail also, we'll discuss.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. So we will providing the mail, and you can contact us personally if you have any doubt or any query. And thank you, sir, for giving us your time and your knowledge. Our students are very beneficial, will be benefited from this. And I hope there are many more coming webinar. So I'll hope, so next time we will be more prepared, and we will try Skype or WebEx, so that okay. We have uninterrupted sessions.
Thank you. Thank you very much for providing the opportunity. Hope I have tried to clear some of the things, but I'm not sure everyone has taken the points. That's why I told, any queries are there, you can make it as a discussion points. We will take it positively and we will discuss. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.